Tutor to lead us in the other segment of the prayer for Europe and the UK. Woman of God, please take over.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Daddy, for giving me this opportunity and for giving me a slot among the saints. May God be the glory, and may God bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
So we are going to pray for this slot 5, talking about the purpose of God. Pray for the governance of the Europe, which I'm going for you. Thank God, I've done a lot of justice over the prayer points. I do not know how it started, that everything started here. And when you look at their laws, and you see that everything about the laws here is from the Bible, then we'll start asking why it's still getting. If the whole thing, if you go into the law, you see everything. The Bible is written. Every law in the Bible is what is written. But now, it is not like that. But one thing we know, God said, we are going to talk about. So let us open the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 14, verse 24. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Yes. The Lord of hosts one, saying, surely as I have thought, so shall it come to pass. And as I so shall it stand. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And we all know that the purpose of God for Europe, for United Kingdom, is for his will, the kingdom to come. The kingdom of God to come on earth. It's the purpose of God for Europe, for United Kingdom, is for United Kingdom to come back to God, for revival to come. It's not his purpose. And it's also not his plan. That if anyone, this nation, this continent will be wasted. And we're going to pray for the governors that they are the ones that are taking decisions. We have had a lot of things happening. Since March 2020, we just sure the government are tired. Don't know what to do. Today they said you have to go, there's a lockdown tomorrow. Release next tomorrow. Every students don't know what they're doing again. Tomorrow they ask them to come to school, even their adults. So we are going to pray for the purpose of God, the plan that God has for this continent, the plan that God has for this nation is for men. His will to be done and his plan to be done in Europe. So we are going to stand out to call out. How will it come to be? Because God said himself has sworn. If God has sworn, it's not for me. God say he's looking for a man, a woman. Thank God. Thank you for the vision. Time like this, a time that the whole world needs a change, in time that the whole world needs revival, in time for such a great vision, and look, standing in the land of Europe, standing to stand for the nation, and I know that I believe the purpose and that plan that any United Kingdom concerning Europe. So let us begin to pray. Say, oh Lord, my Father, arise, oh God, arise, let their purpose, their plan, raise men and women that will bring their plan and their purpose, the governors, the authorities that will bring their plan and their purpose into manifestation. Let us begin to pray. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we are asking, standing at the double calling of at this time of men, raising men and women, raising, oh God, that the government, the authorities that will stand out, oh God, and bring in the purpose of your plan.
Shianda bararaba sianda bararaba siende bele rebo sando buriondo bororobo shiata kabata kabararaba baba sana arianda bararaba sikata kabararaba baba sianda buriondo bororobo shiata bararaba sianda bararaba
sianda bararaba
bararaba sianda bararaba sianda bararaba sianda bararaba sianda bararaba
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Yes, when we look back, look into the Bible, Psalm 24. That's Psalm 24. It said, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. United Kingdom is the Lord's. The United Kingdom is the Lord's, the fullness, and all that are in it. So we cannot stand here to let other people that are not of God to decide, to take decision. Because this United Kingdom is the Lord's. We read the book of Genesis chapter 1 verse 26 to 28. It says, God said, have given us dominion over United Kingdom. So we are going to stand Whatever we call into the offices of the authorities, that is what it will be. God said, I give you authority. And Jesus handed over that power and authority to you and I. And tonight we are going to address the Parliament of United Kingdom. We are going to lift, we're going to uproot, just as he said, we are saying, uproot anything that God did not plan down and plant the children of God that will bring the purpose and the plan of God into manifestation. Let us begin to sing. Let us begin to pray. Oh Lord, my Father, arise. As we speak tonight, begin to speak about your words. Begin to root out everything that God did not plant in the United Kingdom authority.
Yes, Father, these nations belong to you.
In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to live to God. We see what Nehemiah did. Despite opposition, despite oppositions, in and out. Amen. When we look at the book of Nehemiah, we saw what Nehemiah did. There was an opposition. It was in time like this. When things were scattered, there was no hope. There was nothing to write home about this. But a man stood. A prophet like Nehemiah, even when opposition came, he refused to compromise. I'm going to say, Lord, raise men like Nehemiah into the parliament of the United Kingdom. But men that will not be distracted. Men that will stand in upright, in righteousness, in holiness. Men that fear God. Let us begin to pray. Say, raise men, God, in our government in the United Kingdom. Makarikada. Never will stop, oh God, all the iniquities going on. Makarikada. Even the government is supporting them, is standing by their side, sending military men to guide them because they are demonstrating evil. So evil cannot rule in the United Kingdom. No, there is men like Nehemiah.
Oh yes, oh God, Father, we pray. Father, call for the Nehemiahs, oh God. Nehemiahs, oh Father God. Father, we pray that you may raise up Nehemiahs, oh Lord God, in the United Kingdom, oh Lord God, in every country of Europe, oh Father God. Raise up Nehemiahs, oh Lord God, men and women who fear you, oh Lord God, who are there present in the King's Court, who are there present in the Prime Minister's Court, who are there present, oh God, in the President's Court, oh Lord God. Raise up Nehemiahs, oh Father God. Yes, oh Father God, we have a concern for the kingdom. We have a concern for their nations, oh Lord God. Raise them up, Father. Raise them up even in these days. Raise up the Nehemiahs, oh Father God. Men and women who will stand up against every opposition, oh Father God. In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Let us open the book of Isaiah 33, verse 6. We are going to look into some qualities we need in our continent. Amen. You say, there shall be stability in your time. Talk about stability and abundance of salvation. Praise the Lord. So as we continue, abundance of salvation, wisdom, and knowledge. The reverence and fear of God. And worship of the, praise the Lord. We're going to put all this character into our leader. That is what we need. Time like this, we need, in time like this, we need abundance. We need stability. Stability with men that fear God. Wisdom. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So it shall be stability in your time. What to say in our time, in our government, it shall be stability and an abundance of salvation. Abundance of salvation. We need salvation, my brothers and sisters. When you go out for evangelism, you always cry. When you go out, yeah, what people are saying, you tell them, say, oh, I don't think God exists. We Africa, you people know God because you are poor. That is why you pray for God to help you with everything. We have everything here. But now everything is failing them. Praise the Lord. It goes, some people will tell you, the particular in school here, they don't know, children Children don't know anything about God. To uni, enter the uni, talking to them about God. Say, never hear. So we are going to pray. This is the time we need abundant of salvation. We need it. God's grace, few of them, anyone too that will surrender, will see them crying. Jesus is coming back. Yes. Some say I never hear before. So, and this is the nation brought to other. This is the nation that brought salvation to Africa, to many other, to all the world. So now they are just empty. And people are scared of laws. Don't preach religion. Except you meet maybe somebody you are close to. Don't preach in the office. Don't preach in the school. Those are the laws. But on obeying those laws, men are perishing. So we are going to pray for abundance of salvation. Thank God for Pastor Light. For revival. Revival will come down in the United Kingdom in the name of Jesus. Let us begin to pray. What we need, this is the time. But in our government, in government, if there are people, if there are Christians,
is that? Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Udo robo shianda bala raba shianda. Udo koboro robo shianda bala raba 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 raba. Orio boro robo shianda bala raba shianda bala raba shianda. Arianda bala raba shianda bala raba shianda bala raba shianda. Urianda bala raba shianda bala raba shikata kabala raba shianda. Orio boro robo shianda bala robo shianda. Arianda bala raba shianda bala raba sanda. Arianda bala raba sanda bala raba shianda bala raba sanda. Oso toko bo shiata kabata kabala raba shiende. Shindo bolo robo sanda bala raba shiende bele robo sanda. Arianda bala raba shiende bele robo sanda. Bolo robo robo robo. Osha toko bo shianda bala raba sanda. Oh yes, O Lord God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Urianda balarabasi katakabata kabalarabo sando. Uriende belerebo tianda balarabashi anda balarabasi anda. Arianda balarabasi anda balarabasi ende belerebo sando. Urianda balarabasi anda balarabasi anda. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Shitakabata kabalarabasi anda. Arianda balarabasi ende belerebo sando bororobo shanda. Shinda balarabasi anda balarabasi. In Jesus' name, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
So we are going to pray. So I was staying at first in my, if you are among the people that are taking decision from the council in the parliament and you are a pastor, so what are you people telling on that? He said, no, it's not every time you talk. No. I said, but these souls are perishing. We are there, we are not sisters. We are going to pray. People like Esther will say, if I perish, I perish. Say, God, raise men in our parliament, in our government, that will bring the purpose, that will create, that will raise, that will stand like David in our own time. Let us begin to pray.
Oh yes, O Lord God, raise up. Yes, men and women, raise up David, O Father God, in Parliament. Yes, in the circles of government, O Father God, in the name of Jesus. Yes, raise them up, O Jehovah God, in the name of Jesus. So that they be godly governance in the nations of Europe. That is the godly governance in the. Amen.
Pray. You see that Joseph was one of the prominent men, a rich man. And because he was rich and one of the secret disciples of Jesus Christ, because he was rich, he had mouth, have to go to authority and ask, give me the body of Jesus. And they did not hesitate to hand over. Why? Because he's an authority. You're going to say, Lord, raise men and women, infill them with wealth, wealth of this generation that will make them men that fear you, men that are ready to stand even when they are when they are wealthy. That some people like Joseph Arimathea that will stand, and when they start to speak, they will hear. Let there be open doors. Let there be financial breakthrough in the life of the ministers and men and women that fear God. In authority, raise those people in authority so that when they are speaking, those others will quietly and listen, and the word of God will spread. When they're bringing negative laws, those laws, they will say no. And when they say no, it will start. So let us say, God, open doors. The door of wealth, door of wisdom, door of understanding. As according to that that scripture we read, talk about wisdom, talk about abundance of wealth. Let us begin to pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, raise men of God against the most.
In Jesus' name, amen.
We pray for militants. We need the end-time militants, end-time army in the United Kingdom, in Europe, that God will raise men and women that are willing to even to give their life, say, for Christ. Men that will go to look and color. No, they are not afraid of any man. They are not afraid of anything. All they want to want souls. We want souls to be won. People like somebody like David. The brother was asking, why are you here? He said, is there no cause? Somebody like Joshua, that's to say, son, be still until you have finished the business of God. People like Esther, they say, if I perish, I perish. I must defend the people of God. Let us say, God, raise militants, end-time army in the United Kingdom, in Europe, that will go. People that will go to look and color for soul winning, no matter whatever it is, let us begin to pray.
Yes, oh Father God, raise up an army of men and women, oh Lord God, Father, who will stand, who will love even their lives till the end, oh Jehovah God, Father, men and women who will sacrifice, yes, even their lives for the gospel, oh Father God, yes, who will say, I perish, oh Lord God. Men and women, in the name of Jesus, men and women who say, is there not a cause? Is there not a cause for the salvation of souls? Therefore, they will give their all, of Father God, to the cause of the kingdom. They will give their all, of Father God, to raise up, yes, men and women, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, who love you, yes, who seek after your face, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Raise up men and women, oh Lord God, Father, who will be passionate about souls, who will be passionate, oh Lord God, in terms of getting people for Christ, oh Lord God, who will be passionate, oh Lord God, yes, about preaching the gospel, oh Father God, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name,
Son of God, Son of Messiah, we bow before you.
Thank you.
Praise, O God, unto yourself.
Yes.
And army of firebrands,
but love,
men and women who fear men and women that will only
carry on the Hallelujah.
Zana Balagados.
Thank you, Jesus.
Zana Gada Balagados.
In the name of Jesus.
Mana Gada Balagados.
In Jesus.
Je prekete ke ye preketus. Zamana makadegados.
Thank you, Jesus.
Zaprakatare mama kare baba santa.
Amen.
Lita kare mama
santa. Amen. Amen.
Lika Balagados.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We give you honor. Father, we give you honor. Hallelujah.
In the Lord.
Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, we are looking unto you and trusting that the wells which our fathers opened in Europe and UK shall be opened once again.
Amen.
That those wells of revival shall open again. Those wells of revival, those wells of your mighty move shall be reopened, shall be redug again, shall be reopened
Amen.
Again, that there will be a breaking forth of your revival springs all over the nations, all over the cities and communities of UK and entire Europe in the name of Jesus. Have your way, Lord. Let your kingdom come over Europe and let your will be done. Let it be said that the kingdom of God has taken over Europe again. Let it be said that the will of God is done in Europe now. Let it be said that the will of God is done. The will of God is done. Father, give us glory for the instruments you are going to use to enforce your plans in this end time all over Europe and the UK. Father, we pray you strengthen them. We pray, God, you strengthen them. You quicken them. You enlighten their understanding to know what to do, to know where to go, to know what you have them do. Thank you. For your plans will surely come to pass. We shall live to see Europe and UK set on fire for you. We are here. We are going to where. We shall see the mighty move of God in Europe. And that will be an exemplary proof that God is faithful to his word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much, Sister Anne. Thank you. And to Colade for that interesting segment or session of lifting Europe. It's good that you are there and you are doing it right from there. All right. Thank you so much.